children, welcome to your biology class. I hope all of you are fine and safe. In previous class, we started a new chapter, isn't it? What is the name of that chapter? Yes, weather, climate, and adaptations of animals to climate. So, we discussed about the two terms of that title. Weather and climate. Let's recall what we have discussed in the last class. Okay, so what does mean by weather? Yes, weather is the day-to-day conditions of the atmosphere at a place with respect to humidity, temperature, wind speed, rainfall, etc. So these factors are called as elements of the weather, isn't it? Then what does it mean by climate? Climate is the average weather pattern taken over a long period of time. As you know, children, climate has a profound effect on all living organisms. And the climatic conditions vary from region to region. So the animals seen in a particular region must possess special features to adapt to its climatic condition or to survive in that climatic condition. So today, let us discuss about the polar region, their climate and the adaptations of animals to that particular climatic condition. Polar regions. As the name suggests, the polar regions are situated near the poles. That is North Pole and South Pole. Some well-known countries that belong to the polar regions are Canada, Greenland, Iceland, Norway, Sweden, Finland, Alaska in USA, and Siberian region of Russia. Children, what are the characteristics of polar regions? From these pictures, you can clearly understand that these regions are covered with snow. And it is very cold for most part of the year. You know, children, for 6 months the sun does not set at the poles. And other 6 months the sun does not rise. In winters, the temperature can be as low as minus 37 degrees Celsius. Do you believe this? In this extreme climate, it is very difficult for a human being to survive. But there are so many animals like fishes, musk oxen, reindeers, foxes, seals, whales, birds, polar bears and penguins are living in these polar regions. Let us see how they are adapted by considering the examples of polar bears and penguins. Children, these are polar bears. Polar bears have white fur, so that they are not easily visible in the snowy white background. It protects them from their predators. It also helps them in catching their prey. And the second point is, to protect them from extreme cold, they have two thick layers of fur. They also have a layer of fat under their skin. These keep it warm in cold weather. And the third point, it is a good swimmer. Its paws are wide and large, which help it not only to swim, but also walk with ease in the snow. And the fifth point is, it has very strong sense of smell. It helps the bear to locate and catch its prey. So children, let us check what are the adaptations of penguins. Children, these are penguins. Penguin is also white and merges well with the white background. It also has a thick skin and load of fat like our polar bear to protect it from cold. Penguins are good swimmers. You know that fishes have streamlined body and water birds have webbed feet. These features help them to swim, isn't it?
So likewise, penguins also have streamlined body and their feet have webs, making them good swimmers. Children, how warm you feel when you are in a hall full of people? Penguins huddle together. They do to keep warm. Fish can remain under cold water for long. But birds must remain warm to survive. They migrate to warmer regions when winter sets in. They come back after the winter is over. You must have seen or heard about the Siberian crane that comes from Siberia to places like Bharatpur in Rajasthan and Sultanpur in Haryana and some wetlands of Northeast and some other parts of India. But how these birds travel to the same place year after year is still a mystery. It seems that these birds have a built-in sense of direction and know in which direction to travel. Some birds probably use landmarks to guide them. Many birds may be guided by the sun during the day and stars at night. There is some evidence that birds may use the magnetic field of the earth to find the direction. And it is not only birds that migrate. Mammals, many types of fish and insects are also known to migrate seasonally in search of more hospitable climates.
Dear children, please read page number 72, 73 and 74 of your textbook. Attend the test questions. Download the notes and watch the animation of the topic with the help of the attached URL. Thank you for listening to me, children. Once again, thank you. Bye.